So it's a sad day. Weird Stuff is closing shop. And there's a whole bunch of people for a computer museum inside, and we're all crying. Yeah, I bought a few of the stuff I could find. The good HP stuff that was off the web, but they let me buy straight from the store. And then I actually found some of the documentation for my giant IBM printer. And a whole bunch of cables and stuff that will go in my experiments. Sniff, we'll miss them. So that was a sad day indeed, and I have put away most of the stuff here. I still have some of the HP stuff I have to bring down, but I thought, why don't I give you a tour of my collection and show you how much weird stuff had contributed to it. So welcome to my luxury basement, and that's not weird stuff, that's eBay. And here, but yeah, so weird stuff had really weird stuff. So they had a section that was not quite open to the public, but you could go in it once you knew the people, which was eBay. And that's eBay, what they sold on eBay. And they had sometimes optical equipment, so I reconstituted my hologram setup. We have a little hologram here. Oops, it's not there. So these I made a long, long while ago, 1989, when I was a budding scientist. Snuck in the lab, made some holograms. So that's one contribution from weird stuff. So over here we have the Alto. I guess you have seen enough videos of it, and it's working fine now. Give us a fright, the disc went under. Also while we were making the Gizmodo video, I mean everything I touched was failing during that video, but we repaired it. And here are my little Max, and actually this, the disc comes from weird stuff actually, and that's also one that was not on eBay or not in the retail store. They hadn't tested it yet.
Contact. Yep. The fan's not even turning on.
No.
Okay. But what I think is happening is that the drive motor, the drive is stalled. Can't spin. It stresses the transistor and the power supply, so it killed the plus 12 volt. And now it killed the transistors.
So I don't know what to make of this disc here. Yeah, try again. You are kidding me. It's a Happy Mac, it reads the disc. It's Neil's disc. Wow. Now that was worse. Fearing a Macintosh.
Actually, they would have thrown it away because it didn't work. All the stuff that they work for on eBay, they have it tested. This is HP 2116, and that's basically the first HP computer ever. Let's see if I can open it up. Not easily with one hand. There you go. Beautiful machine, and that's the only machine that I have which is with core memory. So this is a HP, what is it, a 6130, so this is 1960s equipment. The reason I bought this one is because it's the same vintage as this, and there is one setup where the 2116 is attached to this power supply, and it's in the catalog, so I wanted to recreate that scene. So it has a weird Centronics cable at the back, and so when I went to weird stuff, I bought a whole bunch of cables, and sure enough, I even found an HP cable that's probably meant to do the interface to the HP 2116. So when you have something missing, in the valley, you'll find it somewhere. This is kind of remarkable. There's another example back here. So here you have the stuff that's sort of in storage or that I haven't quite repaired yet. But here's a good contribution from Weird Stuff. So I had bought on eBay this fiber optic. So that's very early, if not the first fiber optic link for computers. And so I was pretty psyched about getting one. The problem is that it uses a very weird fiber and very pre-standard fiber connector. I couldn't find it anywhere. So I looked for literally years to find the fiber that comes to it. And one day it was at Weird Stuff. And after trying to get the fiber all over the internet, so it's a weird 140 micron fiber with a pre-standard connector, I found it. I was about to remachine one, and there you go. $10. Got it. Over here, there is some weird stuff. This 7550, one of the two is from Weird Stuff. I can't remember which one. One was from Silicon Valley CompuCycle SVC, and they gave it to me for free actually one day I was there. This one was like $25 at Weird Stuff. Like this ThinkJet, this one I think is from Weird Stuff. I have a whole bunch of them. It makes no noise and it's way faster. Here's an other Weird Stuff one. So this one I found in a pile. So the 2631G printer, which I made my ASCII art demo. It didn't work, of course, I had to repair it. Self-test does nothing, line feed does nothing. It looks essentially dead. I need to change this first. Oh, my paper is not wide enough.
Self-test okay.
HP2564, 35 years old. Test. And here it goes. 600 lines per minute, folks. And yes, Weird Stuff helped me out because 2 days ago I was able to find a manual for it, and in particular the serial interface will tell you how to get it configured. If you remember, the whole of the 1200 line per minute Memorex printer, which is written Memorex, but I think it's a data products. Is that thing that makes a noise? And guess what I found on the last day at Weird Stuff? BP stands for Band Printer, and looks the same to me, and it confirms that it is a data product printer that's rebadged by Memorex. And this has the maintenance guide, and I found that too. That's the Pirate Paper Stacker, that's this guy over there, which I discovered was way smarter than I thought. It has actually photo sensors on either side, needs to be adjusted. They had even better BP series, so the band printer. The whole guide is a little dangerous to open because it falls apart, but it has the whole schematics. If I can open this one, block diagram and schematic and boards. And basically I took everything from data product I could lay my hands on, because if I hadn't done that, it would have been lost forever. Go in a trash can. This is a beautiful scope. This is a 1960s scope, I guess, or very early 1970s from HP. And this one, instead of having a reticle illuminator, it just floods the screen and it gives this green glow. It's just fantastic. And look, there is no noise whatsoever. This is from Bob Rosenblum. Bought that from him. It's a 7 little scope. I thought that was cute. Probably hook it up to a 7-track tape. So that's from another outfit in the valley called Halted, or HSC, which almost disappeared. Same thing, their building got bought, which is what happened to Weird Stuff. Their building got bought by Google and they were told to leave. These guys, their building got bought and they had to shrink by a factor of 3 or 5. I bought that RF spectrum analyzer, an 8568B, which didn't work, which I repaired. It was one of my first YouTube repairs, but it has developed another fault now, so I have to repair it again. That's a frequency meter. That's totally analog. It's a resonant cavity, but it's very, very precise. And so that was cute. One of the most important RF analyzer ever made, the HP 8566. Famous because it goes from 100 Hz to 22 GHz. So this is Cold War stuff to make radars. It costs a bundle. This one is actually from SVC in Milpitas. Antennas, that's Weird Stuff. So here's one more Weird Stuff contribution, and I'll get to measure all those one of those days. What else? Oh, yeah, and I wanted to show you this guy. It's come from Weird Stuff on the last day, so I just bought it. And I was browsing their stuff, and they have manuals. And this one is for the 8566B, my big 22 GHz RF analyzer. And I had never seen that little book. Usually they have a very large book, but this was a little handbook. So I was going to say, man, that's not interesting, until I opened it up, and there's a section that's called Operation Verification, and it has a diskette in it. 5 1/4. And so I started to read about it. And guess what? It's a diskette that works on this machine right here to test that RF spectrum analyzer. It takes several hours to go through all the tests. You need to have all this equipment to hook it up and do the test. And it turns out I have most of it. So, gee, I didn't even know that thing existed. Definitely when I get this thing working, this is what's going to do. I'm going to use it and run that HP diskette and put the RF spectrum analyzer to its paces and use all the other testing equipment I have. Weird Stuff, right? It's just amazing, the stuff that was in the valley. That we know. Guess what's going to happen now that their whole stock is going to go in the garbage. I won't get it ever again. Pretty sad.